For a military with the world's largest defense budget, things move at a glacial pace, or so experts say. Therefore, it's surprising that the U.S. Navy actually managed to design, build and test a new ramjet missile in just 6 months. How did they do it? Off-the-shelf parts and credit card. To avoid bureaucracy and miles of red tape, the team behind the rocket decided to keep things small and use off-the-shelf parts. Most of the components, in fact, were simply bought with a credit card. They were also relatively cheap, which allowed the team to test their design more frequently. A normal defense purchase would involve tedious budgeting, red tape and the setting up of contracts. The missile itself is based on a ramjet design, which is more efficient than a regular rocket engine. The ramjet engine is conceptually very simple. The missile's velocity is used to compress air into the engine compartment under high pressure, and this is in turn used to ignite the fuel. The reaction energy propels the rocket forward at incredible speeds. As Popular Mechanics points out, the ramjet design depends on high-speed airflow, supersonic in some cases, to work. It cannot be used to launch a missile. To get the missile up to speed, the rocket motor is required. U.S. Navy scientists decided to buy a commercially available rocket motor, designed for hobby rockets, and used it in their missile. It worked. There was no need to set up the rocket motor factory or contract the unit out to a defense company. It was cheaper to buy the $900 rocket motor than to develop one in-house. Rapid testing helped speed up development, and within 6 months, a solid-fuel, ramjet engine missile was ready. By contrast, India's own anti-ship Brahmos missile, which also uses a ramjet, took many years to develop. The U.S. Navy's prototype rocket claims to offer 3 times the range of a liquid-fuel rocket and is faster